The way I dealt with my inner critic was to obey it completely. It took me 40 years to actually get into art because of my name. Most people think I just use it, even though it's not my name, I just put it on my professional products, but my name really is Kathy Van Gogh, and my father, Hendrik. Hendrik's great-great-great-grandfather is Vincent's uncle. My father, his generation and his father's generation grew up with the whole idea that mental illness was a social stigma. So being related to Vincent Van Gogh was a social faux pas or a social no-no. It started there when I was very young with the idea that being related to Vincent Van Gogh was a negative thing. And then as I came into my own creativity, it was a huge burden to bear. And I think a lot of people must feel that way, whether they have a famous name or not. Even though I've always been really creative, I turned my back on the art world and on myself as an artist because it was just too big and too scary. So I took a chance and I took a class in decorative arts. I was cheating. I was obeying my critic because it isn't painting. And that's why I went into decorative art. I deal with my inner critic by obeying it. Most importantly, I have decided to give myself permission to fail. And I think that was a huge breakthrough for me. I have more bad art than good art. I have a lot of bad art. I just hide it. As soon as you give yourself permission to fail, it frees you a lot. It's not for anyone else to say whether my art is good or bad. All anyone can say is whether or not they like it. It's a good idea to make friends with your inner critic because it's there for a reason. It is giving you feedback. It's not all bad, even if it's negative. Sometimes your inner critic is steering you in the right direction and helping you to be better. Accepting failure or accepting that I'm not going to be my best right out of the gate every time is a really great way to deal with my inner critic and to accept that sometimes it's good advice that I hear.